ओम ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेते।
ओम
ईश्वरो
ईश्वरो
गुरुरात्मेते।
गुरुरात्मेति।
मूर्ति भेद विभागिने।
मूर्ति
मूर्ति
भेद
भेद विभागिने।
विभागिने।
व्योम वद्व्याप्त देहाय।
व्योमवद्व्याप्तदेहाय
दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः।
दक्षिणामूर्तये
दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः।
नमः।
सदाशिवसमारम्भाम्
सदाशिवसमारम्भाम्
शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम्
शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम्
अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम्
अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्ताम्
वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्।
ॐ सहनावतु।
ॐ सहनावतु।
सहनौ भुनक्तु।
सहनौ
भुनक्तु।
भुनक्तु।
सह वीर्यं करवावहै।
सह वीर्यं
करवावहै।
करवावहै।
तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै।
तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै।
ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः।
ॐ शान्ति शान्ति
शान्तिः। ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम्।
ॐ पार्थाय प्रतिबोधितां भगवता नारायणेन स्वयम्।
व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्।
व्यासेन ग्रथितां पुराणमुनिना मध्ये महाभारतम्।
अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवतीं अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम्।
अद्वैतामृतवर्षिणीं भगवती अष्टादशाध्यायिनीम्।
अम्ब त्वामनुसन्दधामि भगवत् गीते भवत्वेषिणीम्।
अम्बरमनुसन्दधामि भगवत् भगवत्वेषिणीम्।
यः ब्रह्मा वरुणेन्द्र रुद्र मरुतस्तुन्वन्ति दिव्यैस्तवैः।
Actually, there's a lag in your voice, no?
It's not coming properly.
Yeah.
Now it's okay, Swami. It
yeah, now slightly. It's okay. Yeah.
You can start. Yam Brahma Varunendra Rudra Marutas Tulvanti Divyestavaihi.
Yam Brahma Varunendra Marutas Tulvanti Divyestavaihi.
Vedai Sang क्रमोपनिषदैर्गायन्ति यं सामगाः। ध्यानावस्थित तद्गतेन मनसा पश्यन्ति यै योगिनः विदुसुरासुरगणा देवाय तस्मै नमः सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वेशे सर्वशक्ति समन्विते वयेभ्यस्त्राहिणो देवी दुर्गे देवी नमोस्तु ते रोगानशेषानपहंसि तुष्टारुष्टा तु कामान् सकलानभीष्टान् त्वामाश्रितान्नान्न विपन्नराणां त्वामाश्रिता ह्यश्रयतां प्रयान्ति सर्वा बाधा प्रशमनं त्रैलोक्यस्याखिलेश्वरी Can you continue? I'm just coming. This prayer, huh? I'm just
प्रयान्ति सर्वशक्ति समन्विते
20th verse. कामैस्तैस्ते वृतज्ञानाः
प्रपद्यन्ते न्यदेवताः
तन्तन्नियममास्थाय प्रकृत्या नियतस्वया यो यां यां तनुं भक्तः श्रद्धयार्चितुमिच्छति तस्य तस्याचलां श्रद्धां तामेव विदधाम्यहम् सतया श्रद्धया युक्तः तस्याराधनमीहते लभते च ततः कामान् मयैव विहितान् हितान् अन्तवत्तु फलं तेषाम् तद्भवत्यल्पमेधसाम् देवान् देवयजो यान्ति मद्भक्ता यान्ति मामपि Bhagavan says, people in general, their discrimination power or their thinking, rutajnanaha, it's just robbed away by tehi kamehi, by different types of desired object. And because of that, they have different type of desired object, anya devataha prapadyante. They propitiate another devatas, and which person propitiate which devata? So Bhagavan says, Svaya prakritya niyataha. They are driven, niyataha means they are driven by their own nature, their own disposition of mind. Tam tam niyama asthaya. They remain asthaya, they remain in their own different type of stipulation. They worship other devatas. And Bhagavan says, I don't have any problem. Let them worship the other devatas. That's why I say, yaha yaha bhaktah yam yam tanum shraddhaya architum icchati. Yaha yaha bhaktah, whoever devotee, yam yam tanum, here meaning of tanum means devatas, different type of devatas. Whichever devatas, they would like to worship, architum, icchati, they desire to worship with total shraddha, shraddhaya, with shraddha. And what Bhagavan says, I used to do, tasya tasya achanam shraddha, tasya tasya, tasya tasya bhaktasya, whatever they have their own bhakta, अहम विदधामि, आई जस्ट प्रोवाइड देम अचलाम श्रद्धा, द फर्म डिवोशन फर्म श्रद्धा, आई जस्ट प्रोवाइड देम, आई डोंट हैव एनी प्रॉब्लम, विदधामि, दैट ऑल्सो वी हैव सीन. And what happened when Bhagwan provides, then says in 22nd verse, last week we have seen this, saha bhaktaha taya shraddaya yuktaha. When Bhagwan provides that firm shraddha, then that devotee is endowed with that shraddha, and tasyaha devataha, for that devata aradhanam ihate, he propitiate, or he engage in the worship of that devatas, and that devatas labhate, it gives, they obtain kaman, whatever kaman they desire, that all vihitan kaman, those tan means those, tatah labhate, they all obtains their own desired objects. And last time we have seen this second line, we can see in different two way. This hitan will go together. Shankaracharya says, hitan kaman vihitan hitan kaman labhate, or otherwise tan vihitan kaman labhate. Here he means definitely, otherwise another is hitan. That we have seen. The meaning of almost same. Tataha, then they, when they engage to propitiate, or when they are engaged to worship, then this all devatas labhate, they give, they obtain tan vihitan kaman, this all desired object. His vihitan means ordained by me only. That devata is not giving to them, but they will give in by me only. Maya eva de labhate. Otherwise, this hita goes together. So generally, the meaning of hita is well-wishing, no, good. Something good is called hita in Sanskrit. But Shankaracharya has put one note, this kaman cannot be hita for any people. Because whatever you desire, this desire is keep on working on you, and you are being asked different type of desire. So this hitan, we cannot translate as a good desire or well-wisher desire. But hitan means only object of desire. So hitan means object, and kaman is also object. That Shankaracharya has clarified in his Bhashyam, that also we have seen. And now, next verse. Antavattu phalam tesha. Shankaracharya has written here, hitaniti padachede, what I have just discussed. If we take hitan as a padacheta, means we joint he and tan together, then hitatvam means some well-wishing. Kamanam upcharitam na kalpyam. We cannot even imagine this all kama is good for any person, because nahi kamaha hitaha kashchit. Anytime desired object are not good for anyone, because they are keep on asking, please ask me, please ask me. So whatever kama you keep, that kama is not good. So which type of kama is good? That what we have discussed many times, non-binding kama. Desires are good. Otherwise, all desires are not good, because they are all are binding. That's why he says, hitaha na kalpyam. We can kasyachit by anyone, this kamaha ahitaha na kalpya. We cannot even consider all desire are good for us, because they are always binding. And when even they labate kaman, even they get this all desired object, but still Shankaracharya says before this 23rd verse, he has put one good line. He says, Yasmat antavat sadhana sadhana vyaparaha avivekinaha kaminaha cha te atah. Kaminaha, one who has desire. And one who has lots of desire, binding desire, according to Shastra, they all are avivekina. They don't have proper discrimination power. Thinking process is not good. And why they are considered as avivekina, Shankaracharya says, whatever they get, that sadhanaha, that means, are always antavata. They all are finite. And whatever we get result from finite karma, that result is also finite. So vyaparaha means whatever activity we have done by finite sadhana means the result is also finite. It's called antavatta. That's why Bhagavan has explained antavat tu tesham phalam. Tesham, tesham alpamedasam, tesham alpamedasam phalam antavat bhavati. So people who are always has less discrimination power, for them whatever they get result, phalam labhate, but all phalam are always antavat, means finite. And one time we have seen, if you remember, whatever we do karma, whatever we perform karma, it has three doshas, three defects. And what are those defects we have seen? One is ke dukha mishri tattva. Whatever karma we do is always fraught with dukha. Dukha mishri tattvam. So arjane dukham. When we would like to get them, at that time also pain, and also rakshane dukham. It is difficult to maintain also, and it will go, it always give pain. So it not only object, it also come relationship, it's also any situation. All are dukha mishri tattvam. Second thing is atrupti karatvam. It never gives any type of satisfaction. According to Pujya Swamiji, it was one aid was there. Give me more. Some coke, something. But Pujya Swamiji says this same way, this Pepsi. Karma, Pepsi.
Dil mange more.
Dil mange more. Atrupti karatvam. Always, whatever we have, we never have satisfaction. It's always atrupti karatva. And last one is bandhakatva. Whatever we do, we think we are the boss of all, whatever object we have, or whatever people around us, but they are boss, they are always slave. Bandhana. Before 100 years, nobody knows, even AC is there, or even, you know, centrally AC or centrally heater, nobody, still people are happy, they are living happily. But now, AC is there, even everything is there, we cannot live without these all gadgets. So, we are bound by this all object, it's called bandhakatva. So, it's make us slave. So, all karmas, and even after whatever we get, is also, all result is also, antavatta. All results are always finite. That bhavati alpamedasam. Alpamedasam means like avivekinaha kaminaha. And still Bhagavan says, devan devayajaha yanti. Devayajaha means one who worshipper of God, they will get devatas. Yanti means they will get. Devayajaha devan yanti. Worshippers of devas, they will get devatas. And Bhagavan says, मद भक्ताः यान्ति माम अपि मद भक्ताः माय डिओटी दे गेट मी दिस इज ओनली डिफरेंस देयर इज ए यू माइट हैव गोन टू कठोपनिषद एवरीबॉडी नोज द फलम इज ऑलवेज फिनाइट but still people go after finite result only. That also, even, you know, Yamadharma Raja is always, I think, is intellectually honest. He praised Nachiketa in Kathopanishad. It is very beautiful shloka, mantra. This is said by Uttam, Yamarajena Uktam. Yamaraja is told this. He says, Janami aham shevatihi iti anityam. Aham janami. Yamaraja says, I know that. And he says, shevatihi. Yet the meaning of shevatihi means treasure. And the treasure is karmaphala. The treasure of karmaphala is anityam. Is always finite. Aham janami. I know that whatever I'm doing, this all result is anityam. Whatever I'm doing punya, because this punya are also anityam. This is very beautiful. Janami. That I know that. And even I know that, he says, nahi adruvehi prapyate dhruvam tat. Tat dhruvam moksham padam. That dhruva, which is always remains same, that dhruva, moksha, is adhruvehi, which are not, which is not limitless. So all objects are adhruva, which is limited. By limited object, I cannot get dhruvam moksha pada. This also aham jana. So two things he says, I know. One thing is all karma phala are nityam, and whatever object I use for getting the best position in Devaloka, this also adruvehi dhruvam na prapyate. That I cannot get. But still, everything I know, but what I have done, he says, tataha maya, even after knowing this, maya by me, nachiketaha, Chitaha Agni. Because everybody knows this story. One who performed Nachiketa Agni and one who meditated the mantra of Nachiketa Agni, that person can get lots of punya. If you perform simply, that person will go to Swarga. But if you meditated all mantras and also perform, then we'll get better loka. So he says, everything I know, this karma phala are anityam. Even I know adruve. This all, whatever doing rituals are also adruve, which is are not permanent, and which is not permanent, I cannot get any permanent result from that. Even I know that, but still nachiketaha agnihi aham chitaha. I did that nachiketa agni, and by nachiketa agnihi praptavan asmi, I have got what the yamarayam. Yamarajasya padam. He says, Yamyasya padam. I have got the position of Yamaraja. And here it is written Nityam. And Shankaracharya has written, it is a relative Nityam. Because post is always relative. Even Yamaraja post or Indra Raja, even Brahmaloka, Hiranyagarbha post is also relative. But it being long, so always is given Nityam. So, okay, Nityam praptavan asmi. And how can I get this Yamaraja post? He says, anityehi dravyehi. All dravya, what I have used in Nachiketa Yagni, I know it is not nitya, it is not permanent. So with all temporaries, different type of dravya, I did Nachiketa Yaga, sacrifice. And because of that Yagna, I have got the post of Yamaraja. You are better than me. He said to Nachiketa Yamaraja, after that he says, you are better than me. After knowing everything, if I have chosen the post of Yama Dharmaraja, but you are better than me. You have rejected everything. So your vairagyam compared to me is very good. Same way, here Bhagavan are saying same thing. He says all worth antavat phalantesha. All result is always finite. But still people love that thing only. Now Shankaracharya explained. So here also Shankaracharya again explained. Again Bhagavan is lamenting. He is annoyed by this attitude of people. Antavat, the meaning is vinashi. It is not permanent. It is subject to destruction. Tu phalam tesha, whatever we perform, whatever we get, everything, all result is always vinashi. So subject to always destruct. Tad bhavati, it becomes for whom alpamedasa. So Shankaracharya has put one more synonym, alpa pragnana. Pragna means we can say discrimination. Alpa means little less. One whose discrimination is not proper. And this person, people, devan, deva yajaha yanti. Deva yajaha means devan yajati. One who worship devas, those people, devan yanti, they will get devas. So devan yajanti iti deva yajaha. One who worship deva is called deva yajaha. Te means those, devan yanti. They will get devas only. Mad bhaktaha yanti mamapi. While my devotees will get me. This is only difference. If they get devatas, that phalam also antavat. Because in those days, the rituals, different type of rituals are very important. If they are Agnihotram, so Agnihotram also can take Svarga. Even they do Agnihotra with some more stipulation, they can go to Brahmaloka. They are different type. But even everything is antavat. But still people are interested in this only. So now again Shankaracharya says, it's one type of lamenting, you know. He says, evam samane api ayase. Even there samana ayasa. Ayasa means effort. To get devata also same effort. And to get Ishvara is also same effort. But still people are mam eva na prapadyante. But still people are not come to me. They never seek to me. They never surrender to me. And if they seek me, they come to me, what will they get? Ananta phalaya. They will get ananta phala. Means that phalam, which is no limit, boundary. But still, that people won't get. Then Bhagavan says, aho khalum kashtam vartate. It is too much pain for me. Kashtam vartate. Bhagavan says, it's pain for me. Iti anukrosham darshayati Bhagavan. In this way, Bhagavan shows it's all lemon. He is not happy with people. So I would like to show something. This. So I just put. So Bhagavan says, samana ayase. So deva yajaha. What they can put afford. So only three way we can do all type of karmas. Either kaikam, vachikam, and manasam. We can do karma, kaikam, vachikam, or manasam. So in kaikam, what these people can do? Even father of Nachiketa, he has done Vishwajit Yaga. In that, all yagas, there are so many contributions. They have to give so many gifts. So distribution of wealth is there. So there are lots of effort. They need more money. Vachikam. They have to chanting mantras for devatas. And even they have to do meditation for all those mantras. Because if they would like to go in better loka. So all they are putting effort. For what? to get Deva post or whatever, Swarga Loka or any Loka. Same way, Bhagwan says, even Mad Bhaktaha Yanti, Mam Yanti. So even my devotee also put same effort. Even Kaikam, means Kaikam Karma, they all are doing puja. They all, best sadhana is Karma Yoga. They all are doing Karma Yoga. Even we all people, one who loves Ishvara, one who has total devotion for Ishvara, we are chanting mantras, many parayanas we are doing. And even Manasam, we are doing meditation. Even for Manasa, we are studying Shastra also. It comes also from Manasa. We are understanding. So both way, we are putting same effort. So all Karma Kandis are also putting same effort. And Bhagwan's devotees are also putting same effort. But the result of this people who are devotee of devtas, is phalam is limited because they will get Devaloka, Pitruloka, Brahmaloka, whatever. And Bhagavan says, Kshine Punye Martya Lokam Vishanti. When the old Punya will get over, again they have to come back to Martya Loka only. So that's why this phalam is antavat. It's always finite. If we worship Lord, Bhagavan says, even just now I remember in 10th, I think 10th chapter it will come. Ye Bhaktaha, what was there? The very beautiful. Aham Gnana Yagnena. Then Bhagavan says, I will provide them Jnana. What was there?
Tesham.
Satata Yuktanam. Bhajatam Preeti Purvakam.
Preeti Purvakam. Tadami Buddhi Yogam.
Yena Mam Upayanti. So Bhagavan says, I myself provide the real nature of me. And the result of is Anantam. And the result of his is Antavanta. And because of Antavanta, the meaning they will born again and again. Still, Punarapi Jananam, Punarapi Maran. While this devotee, Sansara Tramuchyate, they are released from Sansara. And these people are generally Purushartha, is Artha Purushartha, Kama Purushartha. Backed by Dharma, no problem. But this Bhaktaha, devotees, Purushartha is Moksha Purushartha. The result is Anantam and this result is Antam. Which is both, they are putting effort, but still poor people, they will get small result. But still, they don't know. That's why Bhagavan says, again I have put here, Aho khalum kashtam vartante. This all, when we compare both people, then Bhagavan says, khalu kashtam, this is very painful. Khalu means indeed, kashtam means painful. Having seen this, this is really painful. Iti anuprosham darshayati Bhagavan. In this way, Bhagavan has shown his own, his lament, Bhagavan says. He's unhappy. Sometimes what is obvious, no, still we cannot go after. Why? Some prarabdha, some obstruction. That's why I always used to say, we all are blessed. Whatever are interested in Ishvara, we all are blessed. Because we are interested in Shastra, we love Ishvara, we have total devotion of Ishvara, then it will lead Anantam Phalam. That's why we are blessed. We love Shastra, we love Ishvara, that's why we are blessed. So this is, now it is Bhagavan's responsibility, you know. Tesham satatam yuktanam. So he will give buddhi yoga. We need not to worry. This old shloka, what is the beauty of this shloka, you know? Always in Upanishad, Upanishad mantra says what is Brahman. Upanishad mantra says what is Akshara, whatever, what is Atma is there. But the beauty of Gita is Bhagavan himself is just praising himself. This is the beauty. That's why Gita is more powerful in my thinking, because here Bhagavan says, Mam, Mam, from 7th to up to 12th chapter, Bhagavan is just unfolding his own nature. It is, that's why Gita is on Gita Upanishad. They say even Gita considered as a Upanishad, because all whatever we are studying here is nothing other than Upanishad's knowledge. So again, Shankaracharya says, Kim nimittam mam eva na prapadyante? For which reason these old people are mam eva na prapadyate? Why they don't surrender me? Iti uchyate, says, need not to worry, it is being said in the shloka or verse. Avyaktam vyaktimapannam manyante mama buddhayah param bhavam ajanantah mama vyavyamanuttamam. Again, Bhagavan says, this is the main. Abuddhayah mam manyante. Abuddhayah. Generally, when we say abuddhayah means one who doesn't have intellect, one who is totally full. But really speaking, in Sanskritam, there is a one, we will see in all samasai, it will come, this a is for negation. So abuddhayah, sometimes we say in English, I don't have money, I cannot come with you. Sometimes people give answer. At that time, it doesn't mean the person doesn't have total money. Person has some money, but that money is not good enough to travel somewhere. Same way, here abuddhayah means they have buddhi. Some people have buddhi, some intelligence is there, but still that buddhi is not sufficient. It is not good enough to think properly, to take decision properly. Such people are called abuddhayah. It is not totally without buddhi, foolish, but there are people who doesn't have sufficient intelligence to take proper decision. Such people, they consider, they think, they look over me in which way. This is Bhagavan's, again, Bhagavan is Bhagavan's problem. He says, they think of avyaktam vyaktimapan. How they consider Bhagavan. So he says, they think of this mom, you know. This mom means, is it 2 by 1? One who knows. All are adjective to mom. Mom means Ishvara. Bhagavan says, these people think of avyaktam vyaktimapan. The one meaning of avyaktam means one who doesn't have any form. He's a formless avyaktam, which cannot perceive by our 5 sense organ, but still these people think is a vyaktim only. So it's only Krishna. The body of Krishna is only Lord. Is a body of Rama, is a vyakti, no, is a deha. Is only Rama, is vyaktimapannam. They have got this body, is only is Bhagavan, is nothing more than this. They people look at me like this. It's called avyaktam. Another, it is written here, avyaktam means, Shankaracharya is written as a, avyaktam means aprakasham. Aprakasham means they cannot, sometimes we say, no, this object, I cannot understand properly. Same way, the meaning is Shankaracharya has taken is they have taken Bhagavan as a avyaktam, is an object which cannot understand properly. Avyaktam, aprakasham. And vyaktimapanna. When it comes in front of light, we can say, oh, this is this one. But this thing, they cannot understand like this. So avyaktam, being an object which cannot, they cannot understand, then vyaktimapan, they take me differently. Consider me like that. again mama my avyayam anuttamam mama means my avyayam what is bhagwan's nature avyayam is the changeless anuttamam the meaning is which is not better than this uttama means the great anuttama means which is not greater than this anuttamam param bhavam ajanantah the people they don't know my ultimate nature ajanantah anuttamam bhavam ajanantah avyayam bhavam ajanantah param bhavam ajanantah this my nature they don't know who am I who are they abuddhayah one who has no total thinking process these people they consider me like this this is bhagwan says again anukrosham this is also they cannot think properly who am I in generally people always think in general people they always think bhagwan is sitting somewhere else and he is just blessing us he cannot be everything this is common people's thinking it's called avyaktam vyaktiyam apa sitting somewhere and sometime he can come to bless us so who is he that is Ishwar so now Shankaracharya is explaining what is the meaning of avyaktam the Shankaracharya is taken as avyaktam means aprakasham aprakasham means one who cannot understand what is this object what is this it's called aprakasham here prakasha is not self evident not like this but prakasha means in without prakasha we cannot identify object properly is called aprakasham same way avyaktam means because of ajnanam the person cannot understand what is ishvara is called aprakasha and because of this vyaktimapannam and what is the meaning of vyaktimapannam they think prakasham gatam idani now bhagwan is born you know he cannot understand who is all pervading consciousness but think he says it is a formless but now prakasham gatam idani now when they are born as a krishna or they are born as a rama now they are in form now is in light now we can understand this is lord it's called prakasham gatam idani manyante ma they look at me they consider me and who is me mom means bhagwan shankaracharya is explain who is mom means who is ishvara nitya prasiddham ishvaram Ishvara is never, you know, we can never bypass Ishvara. Ishvara is always famous to each and every person. That's why it says Nitya Prasiddha. Everybody knows there is something. Even Einstein says there is something which even time is relative, according to Einstein, because he has some touch about Ishvara or something about Brahman. This nitya prasiddham ishvaram api santam even ish bhagwan mam is ishvara even it is well famous still api even though abuddhayah shankaracharya is again put avivekina but according to avivekina means one who has not proper enough thinking process thinking power if somebody asks even very highly intelligent people maybe we consider as a abuddhaya it means they are not interested in subtle things even this those people are also called abuddhaya there are many you know many intelligent people are available many scientists are available many but even they never think of ishvara so we can consider as a avivekina abuddhaya according to shastra everybody is abuddhi one who is not thinking properly about consciousness or ishvara and bhagwan says param bhavam ajanantah so shankaracharya explain param bhavam means parmatma swarupam the nature of ishvara param means it is endless limitless atma swarupam Param means endless, limitless, Atma Swarupam, the form of consciousness, this people, Ajananta. This is also present active participle. Gachan, like Ajanan, Ajananta, this people are, they don't know. Without knowing, is called Avivekina, which doesn't have proper thinking. Mama, again Bhagavan says, my, Avyayam, who is my original nature is Vyaya Rahitam. I am changeless. But still, we are celebrating Janmashtami. We are celebrating Ram Navami. There are many, no? It doesn't, if people say it is not good, I don't say it is good or bad. But one should go also further. This is only Bhagavan Krishna. This Bhagavan doesn't like. So Vyaya Rahitam, my original nature is Vyaya Rahitam. I am changeless. Anuttamam. The meaning of Anuttamam means there is Niratishayam Madhiyam Bhava. Niratishayam means there is a total excellence. There is a no better than this. It's called Niratishayam. Madhiyam Bhava. My nature is better and there is a no better than this. It's called Niratishayam. Even Ajananta. This is also, they don't know me. Manyante. Still they think they are very good. Iti artha. Shankara says, this is the meaning. Here I have put, Pujya Swamiji has taken this vyakti shabda, no? Vyakti. Avyakta means which is not front of me. And vyakti means which is in front of me. So Shankaraj has not explained, but Pujya Swamiji has explained a little bit different vyakti. He says the meaning of vyakti, we can take one who is always with us, all the time. That consciousness is always vyakta to me, us. This our own consciousness is always vyakta to us, but still they think it is avyakta. That consciousness, even in sleep also, this I am is always with us. Even in whatever experience, whatever thinking we are do, but each and every thinking process, this I am is always invariable. That in a variable I is always vyakta, is always aparoksha, you know? It's always with us. These people, they don't think like this. This Pujya Swamiji's interpretation, vyakti mapan. And we can have one question, why such people are like such buddhi? Why they cannot think properly? Then now Bhagavan answer, because of Maya. What's the problem? Why they are not thinking properly? Why they cannot understand me? So Bhagavan himself is give answer. So Shankaracharya is put here. Tadiyam agnanam kim nimittam iti uchyate. Tadiyam agnanam, this ignorance, for which reason? Iti uchyate, it's being said in this verse. Bhagavan himself is answered, why all people are not after me? While all are others, they worship other devtas. Why they are interested in other forms? Why? Bhagavan says, Naham prakasha sarvasya yoga maya samavrutaha mudhoyam nabhijanati loko mama jamabhyayam. This is very good shloka. Aham prakashaha na sarvasya. Sarvasya aham na prakasha. All people cannot recognize me. And what's the reason? Yoga maya samavrutaha. Because they are surrounded by maya. Again, Bhagavan says, I am mudaha na vijanati. But detail, we will see tomorrow. Any question? Anukrosham. Darshayati Bhagavan. This is very beautiful sentence. I always love. Anukrosham Bhagavan Darshayati.
This Swami TV explained this one time. Swami, this Sangati, you know, that Shankaracharya provides the connection between one verse to the next verse.
It's very beautiful. Yeah.
It's very nice. Yeah. Otherwise, you feel like, what are these verses? They just don't seem to logically follow one from the other.
Very beautiful. Without Bhashyam, no, we cannot understand properly. So this is called parampara, lineage, guru parampara. Without Shankaracharyaji, it is totally misinterpreted. People are still misinterpreting. Because we are also without any clue what would like to Bhagavan convey without Shankaracharyaji. There are many dharmas. Mm-hmm. There are one word has different meaning. Which word, which meaning we can take at what time, we don't know.
The Vyaktim Pooja Swamiji's explanation was beautiful, Swamiji. It's
in Kena Upanishad, we say.
I recollect Pooja Swamiji's explanation of the Purnama, the Shanti Mantra, in which he beautifully explains there is really no distance, it's just a cognitive issue.
Yeah.
Right? It's just a cognitive distance that you have to cross. There is no physical distance between all pervading Vishnu.
Yeah. Very true.
On a lighter note, the last verse you explained, it's almost like, because of Maya, people can't realize me. But it's Bhagavan, it's Maya is also Bhagavan. So he's just playing a game with everyone.
He should have been only. That's why Bhagavan says this. Maya metam prapadyanti, maya metam taranti. One who surrendered to me, they will cross the maya.
Yeah, I remember, I recollect Viritatman, this teaching our class one day, he says, one is intelligent or one is, relatively not intelligent, not using the word, idiotic or stupid. You cannot blame them.
Yeah.
It is what it is. It's just part of the game.
Yeah,
I mean, that is Pooja Swamiji's thing of given, everything is given. So you cannot take credit for your intelligence or blame for your lack of intelligence. Or
we can,
it's all given.
Yeah, we can improve. This is also given.
That's also given. The power to improve.
The power to improve is also given.
That's true.
This is the beauty of
it. That's true. I mean, you don't use this given as an excuse and just stagnate where you are.
Okay.
Yeah, thank you.
Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purname Bhavashishyate Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Sri Gurubhyo Namaha Hari Om.